I've made a copy of ODB63 and I've added a table. Named that one ODB64 before, made a copy of that, and I'm calling this ODB64 Junction Tables Part 2. And if you want to work along with me, download ODB64 before from the website. The table I added is this junction filter table. Opening that up shows we've got our junction filter ID of yes or no, a filter employee ID, and a filter training ID. This table is just like the one we did back when we added in the filter table to filter by department. And you can review those videos if you don't remember why we did things this way. I'm going to create a new form in Design View. I'm coming up to Format, then Page, and I'm on the Background tab. I want a background color of yellow 9. Now I'm going to open up the Form Navigator. I want to add a form, so I'm right-clicking on Forms, adding in New Form, and I want to right-click on this to open up the Properties. Under the General tab, I'm going to change the name of the form to Filter by Employee. Now I'm going to click the Data tab. We want a content type of table and a content of our new junction filter table. And this looks good. I'm going to move this down. And on this form, I want to add in a list box. Now, my form wizards is turned off, so I do not get the pop-up. I'm bringing back out the properties box, and I want a data field of employee ID. Under the type of list content, I want this to be SQL, and for the list contents, I'm going to click on the dot 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 to put us in Query Design View. I'm going to add in the employees table and close the add table or query. I want the last name, first name, and employee ID. Now I'm going to switch into Design View, and I'm going to concatenate the first and last name into a single field. We've done this a couple of times in some previous tutorials. We need to add the concatenation field, which is also known as the pipe symbol. Clicking that twice, I'm adding a space, putting in a single quote, then putting that comma after the single quote and a space after the comma, another single quote, another space, two more pipe symbols, and we already have a space to the right of our concatenation symbol. We need to give this a single field name. We're putting these two fields together to be a single field. I will call this as double quote EMP name. Let's run this, make sure it works. And here we see we've got last name, comma, first name. We also have that required that I added in. To get rid of that, I'm going to add in an where not double quote employee ID double quote equals 0. And this should filter out that first record. Rerunning this filters that out. I'm going to save the query and close the window. The next thing I want to add to this form is a label. I'm going to change the name to say training by, shift enter, employee. Now I want to change the font to be Cooper Black, and we'll make it a font size of 12, and I want to center this. I'm going to move it over just a little bit. I'm also going to add in a button. And this is to refresh the form. We'll call this refresh employee. Then come down to the bottom and make the action refresh form. Now coming back up to our form navigator, I'm going to add in a new subform, a new form. I'm going to rename this to Training by Employee. Coming over to the Data tab, I want a content type of table, the content to be our junction table. And we want to link the fields of the employee ID from the junction table to the employee ID from the filter table. Now on this new subform, I'm clicking that to make sure it's selected. I want to add in, we need to come over to More Controls and add in our table control. I'm going to right click and insert a column as a list box. I'm going to stretch this out to fill up the whole box. Now coming to our properties control, I want to select that field we just added onto our table control. I'm going to change the label to say has had training of. Then we'll come to the data tab, and down in the data field, we want this to be the training ID. Changing the list content to be SQL. We need to add in the training information. So the training table, add, close, course name, training ID in that order, and we've talked about this in previous tutorials. Let's run this. Looks good. Save and close. That looks pretty good. Going to close a few windows here. Now to make this group all together a little better, I'm going to add in a rectangle. And I need to send this to the back, so I'm going to right click on the rectangle, arrange, send to back. I'm going to change the background color to be a gradient, linear yellow brown. I also want to make the border a little bigger. I'll make that 0.06 and change that color to be black. Now I'm going to click on the select, make sure that's selected, and I want to select everything I've put on the form so far. Right click and group that together. Now I should be able to move this as a group. I'm going to click design mode on off and see if this works. We need to select our employee. We'll start with David Brown. Refresh employee. And this is asking me if I want to save changes. I'll say yes. and David Brown has had no training. Let's go back into the edit mode again, bringing up the form navigator. I need to put my push button under my subform so we don't get that error message again. Design mode on off. Now let's change this to Donna Lee, since we know that she's got some training. Refresh the employee. And there's her training. Let's also try Kenneth Lopez. Refresh. And there's his training. We'll add the subform to show the employees by the training in the next video, part 3. I will save this form and give it the name ODB64 Junction Tables Part 2. And save the database.